Hello everyone and welcome to Ulysseus European University. Today is 24th of September and we are celebrating European Researchers Night, which is an Europe-wide public event which aims at bringing research and researchers closer to public and to showcase the impact of their work on people's daily life. For this occasion, we are interviewing a number of scientists and researchers from the 6 partner universities of Ulysseus. It's a great pleasure to introduce you Daniel Huelva, who is full professor at the University of Seville in Spain. He lectures and researches at the Faculty of Economics and Business Administration and at the Instituto de Estudios sobre América Latina of this university. His prevalent topics of research are focus on urban economy, as well as agrarian and agri-food sector, particularly in Spain and also in some Latin American countries, such as Chile, Mexico, or Ecuador. In urban research, his analysis are focused on the effects of speculation on housing prices and on actually existing conditions of habitability. Thank you very much for joining us, Daniel, and welcome to our series of interviews.
Thank you very much, Elena.
So, could you tell us why did you choose to work in science?
Well, when I was studying, I was very worried. I was very concerned by problems related with development, economic development. I am an economist, and when I was a student, I was very interested on all these issues, all related with economic development, with well-being, with quality of life, with environment, and all these issues. After finishing, I started to work with issues related with economic development, but more in more concrete territorial context. And that means in the regional development and all related with this. And that's why I started and I went into different kind of research that now are focusing on topics that are related with the first one, but are quite different.
Okay, great. So what is your area of expertise in what you've mentioned before, or areas of expertise?
Well, I have two, as you said before. The first one is related with human, because I started to work with territorial, the interplay between territory and economy. And finally, when you work on this interplay, you have to go down some specific context. So in that way, I started to work on rural areas, and particularly in rural areas, it's very important for food production and consumption. So I started to work with what we call agro food system. That means the integration of production, industrial transformation, distribution, and consumption. We see all those issues as closely related. We can't understand production without understanding consumption. All those elements are together. And that's one of, this is probably my main area of expertise. And when you study all those areas, you also realize that there is some social and environmental issues that are very related on how we produce, how we make the industrial transformation of the different foods, how we distribute those foods, and how make the consumption of food. So finally, social issues and environmental issues are very integrated in my job.
And how these areas of expertise contribute to a more sustainable Europe?
I think I have already answered. It's closely related. If we want to make a more sustainable world, we have to make different sustainable transition in urban issues. We have to change absolutely the way of working of cities, for example, in terms of mobility. We have to change also another elements of the system, as energy, for instance, or as food production. Food production is one of the key topics in any approximation to make a more sustainable world. And sustainability is closely related with our researches, for instance, in production system, no? Because food production has a lot of environmental impacts, and there is ways, different alternative ways, as agroecology, as organic production, as intensive integrated production, which tries to reduce this footprint, but ecological footprint that's, ecological agrarian production has.
And could you tell us one exciting project you're working on this area?
Well, we are working on different projects now. Probably one of the most exciting we are starting at is the analysis of circular economy, and particularly the production of energy, and the production of energy using some residuals coming from agriculture, particularly in the case of biomass, in the case of olive oil, for instance, where olive oil have some subproducts that have not exploited, cannot be exploited, and also can be considered a waste, as alperujo, no? That is a pollutant that can be used, and in fact is being used as a material for the generation of energy, for energy generation. And that's one issue that we are studying now. The economic effects and the social effects and the way that economy has to change in order to can exploit all this resource that now is a problem but can be considered a resource, and that need the development of the change of, in regulation, the change of some firm strategies, but also the development of some specific agents able to make some kind of work that today are not performed.
Interesting. And could you tell people one thing they can do? I know it's difficult, but one thing they can do to contribute to a more sustainable Europe?
I would like to say different things. First, we have to collectively, we have to make it, surely we are going to make, because we are obliged to make big changes in the next years. I think the main responsibility and the main changes is not from the side of specific individuals, but we need regulation, we need public policies, and we need collective action. Saying that, there is also, I think it's secondary, but people can do a lot. Saying that the change cannot be made alone by people. We need something else. But for instance, if you, it's my field of expertise, that is food, we can have a more vegetarian diet. Meat production is has a lot of ecological impact. And vegetarian production has too an economical impact, but in general is lower. So having a more vegetarian diet is good for environment and it's good for our health. We have now a problem of excess of meat consumption that is not good in general. I speak in general because there are many people and each one eat differently. But in general, our diet has a problem of excess of meat consumption. To reduce meat consumption is good for our health and it's good for environment in general. We can make a lot of things, more things in terms of food, for instance, to support local food system and food of proximity is good because you reduce the number of kilometers that food has to travel, and this is also a main ecological problem. And also, you can support system of agrarian management that are better for the environment, and there are many. You can support organic production, you can support integrated production, that are forms that in different degrees tries to reduce the impact of agriculture on the environment. So we can do a lot, the transition is more complicated than a change in individual behavior. The changes in individual behavior are absolutely necessary, but are not enough.
Great. Well, thank you very much for all the tips and also for taking part in this initiative, Daniel. Thank you.
Thank you to you. It has been a pleasure.